Hey, what's going on, guys? My name is David, and today I'm going to show you how to overclock your graphics card. The gameplay you're seeing is Crysis 3. It's going to be rather short for the introduction and just something for me to talk over. The game mode is Assault, which is like Search and Destroy in Call of Duty with no respawns. I go 6-1, but I'm going to shut up about the gameplay now. I'm going to begin with basic terminology and a background on how overclocking works. Then I'm going to go through a step-by-step. If at any point during my background discussion you feel like you've got a pretty good handle on the terminology, just click the annotation on screen to skip to the step-by-step. Overclocking means setting your graphics card to perform at a speed higher than what is recommended by the manufacturer. To do this, the card has to draw more power and more heat is generated. Clock speed means how fast your graphics card is performing, and it is measured in frequency units of megahertz. 100 megahertz means the graphics card is going through 100 million cycles per second. Overclocking can have the benefit of getting your current graphics card better performance. However, it is not without its drawbacks. As mentioned previously, you will be using more power, and that will be reflected in your electricity bill. To keep the card cool, you will have to deal with correspondingly more noise. You will also shorten the lifespan of your graphics card. Before you overclock, and I cannot stress this enough, you must have realistic expectations. You're not going to make your graphics card perform a whole generation better. If you manage to get an increase of 10 frames per second from 50 to 60 frames at the setting that you want to play at, that is already a fantastic overclock, quite possibly a best case scenario and better than what most can hope for. Overclocking is not as relevant in 2013 as it has been in previous generations of graphics cards. For example, if an older card has a clock of 750 MHz and you pushed it to 850 MHz, that's an improvement of 13%. But for a new card, you could have a clock speed of 900 MHz and with an overclock to 1000 MHz or 1 GHz, you get an improvement of only 11%. These are just example numbers, but the principle is the same. You get diminishing returns. Another big reason why overclocking is not as relevant is because Kepler cards, aka the Nvidia 600 series, have built-in boost, meaning that as long as your card is not reaching its maximum power limit or heat, and the game is graphically demanding enough, it will overclock itself. Each model of GPU has its own Kepler boost amount, but it is always in multiples of 13 MHz. Nonetheless, it is a satisfying endeavor to perform overclocking as you know you are getting the best possible performance out of your hardware. Your warranty should still be intact even if you overclock. However, if you are using an OEM graphics card from a pre-built system, sometimes they are locked and cannot be overclocked unless you use software to force unlock them. In this case, you will void your warranty. Modern graphics cards are for the most part idiot-proof. It is extraordinarily difficult to destroy your hardware. There are many fail-safes to ensure continual operation. If you do try to hit too high of a power target, the card will throttle back its clock speed by increments of 13 to prevent you from destroying it. If you do reach a temperature too high, again, the card will throttle itself down, usually in increments of 13 MHz. In a last-ditch effort to prevent you from killing your card, your computer will perform an emergency instant shutdown. You probably had to actively try hard enough to fail. If you do manage to destroy your graphics card by attempting to mess around with the core voltage or otherwise, then I will get all my subscribers to sign a congratulatory card and I will personally hand it to you. I'm going to demonstrate everything on an EVGA GTX 670 4GB, and I will also demonstrate it in SLI, but it works just the same way. Just substitute your graphics card model in any of the demonstrations I show. First, you should look at your graphics card product page to find its core specifications, maximum operating temperature, and power requirements. You should also check if your card is manufacturer overclocked to any extent. If it is, it will be designated superclocked or FTW. FTW meaning that the manufacturer already set it to their determined max clock. This is important and crucial to a later step. My GTX 670 is superclocked, has a maximum operating temperature of 97 degrees Celsius, but I never intended to get anywhere close to that, and a power draw of 170 watts. I'm positive my 750 watt PSU in my PC will handle an SLI overclock fine. Next, download the software that you will use to perform your overclock and conduct your overclock benchmarks. I like the user interface and the feedback of MSI Afterburner and MSI Combustor, so I will use those two programs. Their download link is in the description of this video. Other programs to consider are PrecisionX and UniEngine Heaven, and you are free to fool around with those if you want. Then, while waiting for installation to complete, I would do a Google search to see what people have been setting power target to and overclocking their cards to, so you can have an idea of what to expect. However, every graphics card is different. Even graphics cards of the same model are different, and their overclock ability can vary. Now, in MSI Afterburner, go to Settings, then check Unlock Voltage Control, Unlock Voltage Monitoring, and then OK. The application will restart. Next, you will have to adjust your power limit according to what your Google search has shown is safe. I will put mine at 120%. And I'm going to hit Apply. If your GPU is not superclocked, then adjust the core clock upwards by an increment of 100 MHz. If your GPU is superclocked, then adjust upwards by 50. I have a superclocked GPU, so I'm going to start with a small overclock of only 50 MHz. If your GPU is FTW, then you won't get much benefit from any adjustment you do yourself because the manufacturer's already overclocked it. Then you're going to hit Apply. Now we will go back to Settings and set our fan profile to automatically work harder before our graphics card can hit its first throttling point. You can use the points that I'm showing you on this graph, or you can use whatever points that you want. So when I have my temperature at 50 degrees, I have my fan speed at 50%. If I have my temperature at 65 degrees, then I have my fan speed at 65. And it's really your personal preference. It depends on what brand card you have, the cooling that they use, and what fan noise you are comfortable with. The first throttling point on the GTX 670 is 70 degrees. Like mentioned previously, there is a trade-off with faster fan speed in exchange for faster performance. Save the settings, then click OK. So now we're back at the front of MSI Afterburner, and we're going to click User-Defined Settings on. There we go, and we're going to hit Apply. The cool thing about MSI Afterburner is that there are profiles that you can save your various overclock settings to. You can also manually set your fan speed. Automatic speed monitoring will take a very small, about 0.2% of your CPU resources, but I wouldn't worry because most games don't get to the top of your CPU. Then we will run MSI Combustor. So this is the Combustor page. You can set whatever preset you want. So I'm going to set mine at 1080, or just for the 3D test, you can run the presets. So I'm going to start with my presets and hit Begin. Now what this is going to do is it's going to put a very tessellated 3D object on the screen and stress your GPU as best as it can. You'll know what I'm talking about as soon as you hit the run the preset button, but for the sake of video time, I'm just going to continue with this tutorial. If Combustor is stable and it makes it to the end of the test, then you can make your own tweaks by adding 50 MHz until your card runs too hot, and then reducing a few MHz until you do get a good balance of performance and temperature. If you see some graphical artifacting but Combustor hasn't crashed, then you are running too high of an overclock. Graphical artifacts look exactly like a glitch in the Animus. If you played Assassin's Creed before, you will know exactly what I'm talking about. To find a good overclock, it is some trial and error. This won't be as accurate as the longer methods of overclocking, but it is a good start and you have already gained quite a bit of experience. You will notice that I haven't touched the memory offset. Most people won't gain very much from a memory overclock. It can certainly help with lots of anti-aliasing, running a game with lots of texture mods like Skyrim, or gaming at high resolutions like on triple monitors. But for single screen 1080p, regular overclocking should be good enough. For SLI configuration cards, overclocking works the exact same way. If you have cards from different manufacturers, or if one of your cards is already manufacturer overclocked, both clocks will default to the lowest clock speed. I have SLI disabled at the moment, but you do see some temperature readings and some usage readings for both GPUs in the MSI Afterburner graphs. As soon as I enable SLI in the NVIDIA control panel, then in the Afterburner settings, overclocking works the exact same way. Testing in Afterburner is one thing. You really have to start playing some games to really see if you have a good overclock. Go with the most graphically intense game you own. I'm playing Crysis 3 on very high everything, and you can see the MSI Combustor indicator showing the total usage of my cards and their temperatures. Crysis 3 is a good benchmark game because it is the most graphically intensive game to date. If your game crashes, reassess your overclock. If you can play the game for hours without crashing, then congratulations, you have successfully overclocked your graphics card. Thanks for watching, guys. I really hope I was able to help you. Let me know if you have any questions. Be sure to leave this video a like rating and subscribe if you're new to my channel. Enjoy overclock gaming, and I'll see you next video.